subnet a class C IP address in a fast way. You know, a lot of people have problems with this, and they tend to use a third-party application. Some use an Excel and all that. But if you know what you're doing, you can pick an IP address from this class and then subnet it immediately, and then do what you want to do. So we are going to pick up a class C IP address 192.168.0.0. Normally, the default subnet mask for class C is /24. Assuming you are not doing any subnetting, this is going to give you IP addresses from one to the last valid one, which is 254, and the broadcast is going to be 255. But everything here, if you do this, will be on the same network. So subnetting actually starts when you want to break this network into 2, 3, 4, depending on the subnet mask you're given. So for class C, you can do actually from 24 down to 30. We cannot do 31, we can't do 32. I'll give you a reason for that. So, but let's just take for instance that we want to subnet a class C IP address with a given subnet mask of say maybe /27. Remember I told you that you can do from 24 to 30, okay? So if you're given this and you want to subnet it, it's very easy. So you just look at the subnet. It actually means borrowing bits from the host bits to add to the network bit. So when you have this, this actually means that you have 27 bits turned on, and then you have the remaining 5 bits turned off. The total bits you have in an IP address is 32. Of course, that's why an IP address is defined as a unique 32-bit address that connects a host, or that uniquely identifies a host on the network. So when you are giving 27 out of 32, it therefore means that you have this as your subnet mask, 255 dot. Each 255 represents 8 bits on. Another 255, that's how many now? 16, right? We pick another 255 here. This is going to give us 24. You see, we got it to 24, which happens to be the default, but now we still have extra 3. So that means we are borrowing from the host bit now to add to this subnet bit. So when we have 3 bits on, it's going to be 2. Okay, let's be sure. So 2 raised to power, if we have this, we have in this 8 bits, therefore means that we have 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay? So this actually means if you are rating it, this is going to be 2 raised to power 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So if we say 2 raised to power 5 is going to give us 32. 2 raised to power 4 is going to give us 64. No, 2 raised to power 6, sorry. It's going to give us 64, right? Y2 raised to power 7 will give us 128. So if we add up everything here, 128, 64, this is going to give us 12, right?
Yes. Sir.
2, carry 1. Then this is going to give us 91, 192 plus 32. Okay? It's going to give us 4, right? And this will be what? 12, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
So it's going to be 224, I was right? So right here now, this subnet mask now will now be 224 in this octet. Okay, so if you have this now, what we are going to do from here now is to subnet. And the first question you answer when you're subnetting is, how many bits did you borrow? So if a class C gives you a default of 24 but you have 27, how many did you borrow? 3. So that's going to be 2 raised to power 3. So 2 raised to power 3 will give us what? 8, right? So it therefore means that we say our number of networks or subnets will be what? 8. This thing, subnet, like I told you, means you're breaking down a network into a smaller network. So therefore, we have just, been able to prove that given /27 with a class C IP address, with a class C network address, sorry, that we can generate 8 subnets, 8 smaller network. So the next question you're going to answer is, how many hosts, okay? How many persons or computers or devices are going to be in each of these 8 networks? That's the second question you should answer. So that one is here, the formula for that one is here, 2 raised to power y minus 2, okay? Such that y equals to number of bits off. Remember when I did that binary numbers when I said 11 and 00? So if you have 32, but you're giving a 27 bits as on bit, how many do you have of 5? Right?
Yes.
So you just put those values in place of y. So this is gonna be 2 raised to power what? 5 minus 2, which will give equals to what? 32 minus 2, which will give us equals to 30. That means that in each of these networks that we're going to generate, we're going to have what? 30 users. So we come back here, wipe off all these things. Number of hosts per subnet is going to be what? 30. The next thing you're going to get, which happens to be almost like the last one, is the range at which you're going to group the network. So we do that by using a block size. Our block size will be a constant value of 256 minus the value you have in this last octet of your subnet mask, which is a 224. This will give us equals to 32. So it therefore means that our network is going to take shape in 32. One thing you should remember is that when you are dealing with the host, you do not minus anything. The formula to get this one for the host is 2 raised to power x. You don't minus anything. Where x equals to the number of bits borrowed. So if class C is 24, but you're giving 27, therefore means that you borrowed 3 bits from the host bit. So this will be 2 raised to power 3. That's how we got 8. But for the host, it's going to be 2 raised to power y minus 2, where y equals the number of bits off. So we therefore say 2 raised to power 5 minus 2, and we got what, 30. So generate your block size, the range in which your IP addresses will be grouped, is going to be this constant value of 256 minus whatever value you have in this last octet of your subnet mask. And what we have here is 224. So we say this minus 224 and we have 32. Okay? The next thing is for us to list out our network. Now we are done in block size of 32. So the first network is going to be network 192.168.0.0. You must start from 0. And then when you're doing this, you must note where the subnet occurred. The subnet bit falls into the last octet. So that's where the change is going to be occurring, in increment of 32. Mm-hmm. So the next network is going to be 192.168.0.32. Plus 32, now you now have 192.168.0.64. You add 32 again, 192.168.0.96. Okay? Mm-hmm. How many have we listed? 4. 2, 3, 4. Have we?
Yes.
So we list the next one, 192.168.0. If you add 32 to here, I think you should get, what? Is it 120 something?
Yes, 128.
128, right?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yes.
So we have 128 here. The next one will be what? 192.168.0. If you add 32 to 128, I think we're going to have 160. 160, I think so. Yeah? So if we now add 32 to 160, we're going to have 192. 192.168.0.192. The last one, if you're correct, will always fall back to this one. So if we add 32 to this one, if we don't get to 24, you know we are wrong. So here is going to be 192.168.0.224. So these are the networks that we have now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, what?
8.
Now, in between these networks, you now have the IP addresses you are going to give to host. It means that the first person on this network, 0, will be 1. Second person, 2. All of them will be 192.168.0.1, 192.168.0.2. The last valid host on this network will be what? If you, the next one here is 32. The last valid host here will be 30. Remember this? To be 30. 31 will be the broker. Broker's address don't give to anybody. The broker's address is an IP address through which everybody on that network can be reached. So if I send a packet to IP address of 192.168.0.31, everybody on network 0 will receive that message. Okay? So the first person is 1, second person 2, the last is 30, broker's is 31. Here 2, okay? The first person is 33. 34 down to number before the last number to this network. So the last valid IP address is going to be 62. The broadcast will be 63. Okay? So assuming now that we are using network this, network 0/27. If you go and give somebody the IP address of 33, you are wrong, because you will not be able to communicate with anybody here. Right? Is it clear?
Yes.
So, I was just doing all this whole thing because I needed to be more detailed.